फ्रेंड्स, आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू. प्लीज़ गिव मी अ क्विक थम्स अप इफ माई ऑडियो वीडियो इज़ फाइन. एंड देर वॉज अ हैवी रेनफॉल एंड दैट इज़ वाई देर वॉज अ लिटिल डिले इन द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द क्लास. सो प्लीज़ वेलकम एंड ऑल ऑफ यू, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम इन दिस नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ लेट्स क्रैक नीट पीजी. नाम डॉक्टर चेष्टा अग्रवाल, योर नीट पीजी एजुकेटर ऑन एन अकेडमी एंड आई हैव माइसेल्फ स्कोर्ड ऑल इंडिया रैंक 261 इन माई एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन. यू ऑल आर ऑन द बेस्ट ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ An academy and that is NEET PG. So you all are on the best platform for the preparation of NEET PG and that is An Academy. Download the An Academy learning app from the App Store. You choose your category, that is NEET PG. And once you choose your category, you can go for the free classes and the paid classes. The free classes includes the special class, while the paid classes includes the Plus subscription and iconic subscription. Now in Plus subscription you get the free live classes, the structured course, live test and unlimited access to the platform. While for iconic you get both An Academy as well as Prep Ladder. So you have both the options available. I request all of you. Now we have integrated clinical batch courses also, which works and visible to all of you. Please give me a quick thumbs up if my audio video is fine. Okay, so we have an integrated clinical batch course where you have dual educator approach. These are specifically dedicated for your NEET PG entrance examination, where you can have dual educator classes. The new batch for FMG is starting on 21st. For NEET PG it is starting on 16th of July, and for the next exam again on 21st, the professional year batch course, where the first prof, second prof and third prof will be discussed in detail. I request all my dear students to please go ahead and subscribe, or just go ahead with a 2-month subscription of An Academy, which is very, very important for your NEET PG preparation. I request all my dear students to please use the code CHESHTA10, or they can even use Dr. CHESHTAYT for subscription to An Academy. We have a very limited time period offer going on for the iconic subscription, as well as the 4-year subscriptions which are available for 60,000 rupees of plus and 75,000 rupees of iconic. Now we have revised prices. Please remember, we have revised prices for the both plus and iconic. You need to put a code, and that is Dr. CHESHTAYT or CHESHTA10. Longer the subscription, lesser will be the per month cost, so please try to keep that in mind. We also conduct a bug bounty program, that if you feel any inappropriate content in the video, you can report and claim your prizes. Starting with the today's first question, the case scenario. Please remember, pemphigus vulgaris, the case scenario becomes a very, very important case. 50-year-old female present with a history of erosions in the buccal mucosa, blister on her upper chest and back, and on examinations bullae are flaccid, filled with clear fluid. What is the clinical diagnosis? Please answer this question, all my dear students. Very important. Now, just concentrate to what I am telling you right now. Whenever you get a case of vesiculobullous disorder, always look for the following features, that is, whether there is presence of fluid-filled lesion in the forms of vesicle, which is nothing but a fluid filled lesion of less than 0.5, or there should be presence of a or there should be presence of a bullet. Now even you can have in the question the presence of crust and erosions, which also tells you that you are dealing with a vesiculobullous disorder. So please remember, if any one of them is present, please always think about vesiculobullous disorder, either vesicle or bulla or crust or erosion. The next thing is, the vesiculobullous disorder has been grouped into two broad groups. One is they are immunobullous, and another is they are mechanobullous. Immunobullous means they have autoantibodies, while mechanobullous means there is congenital deficiency of one of the component of dermis or epidermis. Understood? Chalo. Now starting with the immunobullous disorders, the most important is, we have divided immunobullous into intraepidermal, where the level of cleft is inside the epidermis, and we have divided into subepidermal. How they differ clinically, please look at this page. For intraepidermal, you tend to get flaccid bulle. For intraepidermal, you tend to get flaccid bulle, and for subepidermal, you tend to get tense bulle. You tend to get tense bulle. Understood, all of you? So you have flaccid bulle and you have tense bulle. Flaccid bulle means the roof is very thin. So always, if the question tells that you have flaccid bulle, please think. They say that there are presence of flaccid bulle, think about intraepidermal. Now the question is, why intraepidermal present with flaccid bulle? So I just want you to concentrate over one slide. I think that will help you understand the concept. Now I think everybody knows that this is stratum corneum. Below stratum corneum you have the granular cell layer. Anybody can tell me what is this? This is stratum granulosum. Below stratum granulosum you have a thickest cell, which is made up of polygonal cells. Thickest cell layer made up of polygonal cell, stratum spinosum. Which layer is present below the stratum spinosum? You have a single columnar epithelial cells, and what is this called as? Stratum basal. You have basement membrane, and below the basement membrane you have dermis. Now just think, if there is split present somewhere inside. So let's draw or let's highlight it. That becomes very easy. Suppose you have split at this area. Just imagine that we have a split at this particular area and we are just removing these cells. So if you have a bulla which is present here, tell me what is the roof. Roof is formed by only few layers of stratum spinosum, stratum corneum and stratum granulosum. So obviously the roof is thin and you will see flaccid bulla whenever the split is intraepidermal. But just imagine, when the split is subepidermal here, the whole thickness of epidermis is forming the roof, and that is why you see a tense bulla. Is that clear? The difference between a flaccid bulla and tense bulla, very important. This is something which you should know for your entrance examination. Now just taking you back to the today's question. A 50-year-old male presented with erosion. So I have told you, if they have given vesicle, if they have given bulla, if they have given erosion, or if they have given crust, please think about vesiculobullous disorders. Or you can also think about the infectious disorder. But here the vesiculobullous disorder becomes very, very important diagnosis. Okay? Now the another point is, they have given that the bulla is flaccid. The bulla is flaccid, it means they are talking about intraepidermal acantholytic disorder. If this is clear, please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood. So let's discuss what all are the intraepidermal acantholytic disorders. I want all of you to please concentrate on this image. The intraepidermal is divided into three types. One is subcorneal, which is called as granular cell layer. Second is the spinous cell layer cleft. And the third is suprabasal cleft. So inside the epidermis, we have three types: subcorneal, spinous, and stratum basal layer. Please remember, in the subcorneal, the example is pemphigus foliaceus. In spinous cell layer, the example is viral blisters like herpes simplex, herpes zoster. While in basal or suprabasal, the characteristic example is pemphigus vulgaris or some of the congenital acantholytic disorders like Hailey-Hailey disease and Darius disease. Please remember, this becomes a very, very important slide. The subepidermal include bullous pemphigoid, dermatitis herpetiformis, and the mechanobullous disorders like epidermolysis bullosa dystrophica and simplex. Now, how to differentiate between the patients of? So let's again show you the question. So we are done and we are clear with the one point, that it is a case of intraepidermal acantholytic disorder. Now how to choose among the pemphigus vulgaris and pemphigus foliaceus? How to choose between pemphigus vulgaris and pemphigus foliaceus? Please remember, in pemphigus vulgaris you will have presence of oral cavity lesions. But in the patients of foliaceous, there is no oral cavity lesion. So this is something which is very, very important, that the oral cavity lesions are present in pemphigus, it is absent in vulgaris, and here they have clearly mentioned that it becomes a case of buccal mucosal involvement. So answer becomes option number one. Now remember that the bullous pemphigoid is subepidermal split. Staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome is subcorneal, that is intraepidermal, but remember that there is no oral mucosal involvement. And toxic shock syndrome, again you have oral mucosa which is involved, but you will have presence of erosions also. The oral mucosa is not involved. You have, in toxic shock syndrome, you have presence of constitutional symptoms. The exfoliation of skin from palm and sole, and you will have presence of or absence of mucosal lesions. The cause is same, because the desmoglein 1 is affected in the staphylococcal infection, and that is why we have marked the option number 1 as the answer. Now a little bit about some bedside investigation I just want to teach all of you with this slide. Now please remember, we do a very, very commonly seen bedside test, and that is called as Nikolsky sign. When you apply the tangential pressure in the patients of pemphigus vulgaris, there is separation of the upper layer from the lower layer. And why this occurs? Because obviously there is intraepidermal gap, so the upper layer, the upper layers are not connected with the lower layers, so they can easily move at the top of it. So that is called as Nikolsky sign. Bulla split sign is also positive. When you mark the bulla and give a tangential pressure, you can see that advancing border has an angulated margins. Now we have few more things. The Zank smear. If you remove the roof of the bulla in the patients of pemphigus vulgaris, and if you scrape the base, you can spread the material on the glass light. You can see something like this. And what are these? These are Zank cells or acantholytic cells, which are round keratinocytes, hyperchromic nucleus, and there is presence of perinuclear halo. And these are nothing but, these are stratum spinosum, the keratinocytes of stratum spinosum layer. Okay, so that is how the Zank smear look like. When you do the biopsy, can you see, this is the stratum basal layer. So you can see supra basal cleft, and the stratum basal, they are connected to the basement membrane with the help of hemidesmosome, and that is why you can see a single layer of the stratum basal connected, and this is called as row of tombstone appearance. So I think that is all which is required. I'll just show you one more image. How does the histopathology look like? Because of deposition of the autoantibody at the intercellular junction, you tend to see a fishnet pattern like this. You can see a fishnet pattern or a chicken wire pattern on the immunofluorescence. Lastly, how to treat? Anybody can tell me what is the treatment modality or the best way to treat a patient of pemphigus? Always, steroid becomes the mainstay of therapy. You can give conventional 1 mg per kg per day. You can even give pulse therapy, where the large bolus dose is given at a regular interval. And once the disease is controlled, you can shift the patient to non-steroidal or steroid-sparing immunosuppressive agents. A new drug, which is rituximab anti-CD20 antibody, can be given in these patients, which goes and bind to the B cell and causes its destruction. So no B cell, no plasma cell, and further no antibody formation. So that is all about the treatment. I hope you have enjoyed this short case scenario for pemphigus. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel, use the code, or please subscribe to the YouTube channel Let's Crack Neet PG. Take the Unacademy subscription using my referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. Please press the bell icon to get the notification of all my classes, and please follow me on the Telegram group for the further notifications. Thank you all of you.